Welcome to the fourth tutorial in our simple microcontroller series. On this one, this is the last one before we actually start programming the microcontroller itself. So we're just going to set up the circuit itself, and then we're going to set up our project in MPLAB X IDE and do a couple of things there, and we'll be ready to go. And then the next tutorial, we are actually going to be programming things and moving forward. So the first thing we need to do is, if you from, I think it was tutorial 2, saw all the parts you needed to get. Hopefully you have them in front of you, and now let's get them going. So I have my breadboard, I have my PICKit4, and on it you can see there's a microcontroller in the center, and then I have connected to GP2 and GP1 these two LEDs, and then I also have switch 2 and switch 1 connected to GP0 through that resistor right there, and GP3 through that resistor right there. Now, the reason we have resistors on these switches is because just in case you set it up wrong or you have it set up as an output instead of an input, which is what you're going to want whenever you use a switch. If you have that as an output and then you push the button for the switch and it goes straight to ground, that means your 5 volts gonna be straight to ground, you're gonna short it and you're gonna blow that, unless there's some sort of protection in there, most likely you're gonna blow that pin, which is unfortunate. So I put these resistors in there just to keep things safe. Everything else is just connecting things on the breadboard to power, to ground, and then we put in these pins to actually program the microcontroller. Now, in the past, I have set it up where I had a 0.1 inch header with 6 on my PICKit2s. On this one, there's 8 pins. So you could have 8 headers and just stick it right in, and you can actually just plug your PICKit in there like that and it sits up, but it puts a little bit of tweakiness in there, and I decided not to worry about that and I just set it up this way. So you can see what this looks like now. If you want more time to look at this, I highly recommend you go to our website, circuitbread.com, where we have this in a nice, beautiful schematic that is easy to follow, and then you can get this set up and be ready to go. So now that we have this part done, let's head over and check out the actual IDE itself. Okay, so this is your basic what you get when it first opens. I'm not a huge fan of how much just distracting stuff there is in here. Like, I want to kill that start page and things like that. All of that's just fluff that we can ignore. So what we want to do is we want to start a project. And what we'll do is we'll go through and show how to start a project. Once we get our project all set up, we'll also create a main file, and then we'll get it set up so that we can run this programmer to provide power for our circuits, which won't work in the future, but will work for what we're doing now. So first we go to File and then New Project. And then we will want a standalone project. We click Next, and then we can just go here and do one of our baseline 8-bit MCUs and find the PIC10F200. Before moving on, we'll just skip the supported debug header at the moment. And since I am using a PICKit4, I'm going to use a PICKit4. If you've got a PICKit3 or whatever, you can go on. If you've got a PICKit2, obviously it's not supported by this, and you're going to need to use the other IDE, the older one. Now we will use MPASM, so basically MP assembly. Before we're moving on, and I'm just going to call this Primero because it is our first project, and I'm going to keep that set as our main project. I'm just going to keep this under the standard stuff because why not? And it's that easy. I mean, we already have a project set up. It's got the right microcontroller in there. We're good to go. So now we have our project, but we don't have anywhere to put our code. So let's create a new file. We'll just do assemblyfile.asm. Go on. But we don't want to call it new ASM template because that means nothing. So I'll do just main, and as you can see right here, it's main.asm. Again, ASM assembly, just in case that wasn't obvious. And then we will go finish. At this point, you'll want to verify that this is under your project, so main.asm, and you have a blank, beautiful project right here. So that's awesome. Now, one of the interesting things is we talked about one of the differences between MPLAB X and MPLAB 8.76. This one, I almost never hear the fan starting on my computer, but it's starting right now. So obviously this IDE is quite a bit more intense than the older MPLAB. That's not a big deal, but I just wanted you to be aware of it, that if you have some constraints, you may want to use the older version of MPLAB. So now we've got the project set up, we've got our main file set up. Now we just need to make it so our circuit itself is being powered by the PICKit4. So we're going to start right here, and to get power, we're going to go up to File, Project Properties, Primero. and it's gonna pop up. And now on the left, mine says PICKit 4. If you're using something else, it's gonna be something different. Click PICKit 4, then go over to Option Categories, drop down to Power, should be a little bit obvious, and then Power Target Circuit from the PICKit 4, and that's it. So now the PIC10F200 can run at 5 volts, so we don't have any problem. If you end up using a different microcontroller and it can only go up to 3.3 volts, you need to make sure that this voltage level is no higher than the max voltage level of your microcontroller, and you should be good. And then you click OK. And that's it. Now we are all set up. So the next step is, in the next tutorial, we're gonna put some code in there. We're gonna learn about what that code is doing, and we are going to turn on an LED. I know that is super exciting. Just control your excitement, but jump right into that next tutorial and get going. Hope you found this video interesting and also useful. If you did, please give it a like, subscribe to our channel, and we'll see you in the next tutorial.